pickup truck.
It was there all, literally from 7 this morning until...
No way.
Yeah. Leaking fluids all, you can see on the pavement, it's leaking.
Yeah, it's coolant fluid. There's nothing really the fire department can do about that, but about the coolant, oil or something, the speedy dry, but the coolant.
They towed it off with their pickup truck fire?
Water based, yeah. Well, I just got here at 3, so...
Oh, okay.
I came across it around...
When I was there, when I went home at 4:30, it was some car still piped in.
Yeah, and when I came home, I figured, your car broke down, but the whole front end...
Yeah,
was laying on the ground. Yeah. All the undercarriage was on the ground. So you're on the wrong side of the road.
It's better than being on the right side of the road there, I would think.
Yes.
It's on the wrong side of the road. At least you're coming down here to drive. You've got a long way to see it.
You'd be surprised at the way people come flying around, pulling in. But anyway, well, it's gone now, so it's good.
Yeah, they towed it away. I drove by a half hour ago and it was gone. So.
It wasn't there when I took the dogs out at 7. And then when I left for work at around 8, it was mysteriously there, so I don't know.
Oh, I have no idea.
Very strange. All right, we will open the public hearing at a little past 6 on the proposed change to the zoning, the transfer station ordinance. And apparently she didn't print out the copies. Yes, she did. They're over here. There are copies that folks want to see it. I can walk people through it real quick. Are there any questions or any comments? The substantive change really has to do with landlords and who is a resident and who is not, who is allowed to have a transfer station sticker, who is not. The current ordinance is a little ambiguous, so we want to try to straighten out a little bit of that language. If you're not a resident of the town, you don't qualify for a transfer station sticker. You have to physically live here in the town. The garbage has to be generated here in the town. If you're a landlord, you don't qualify. If you have more than 4 units in your building, you have to provide garbage removal, either a dumpster or rubbish removal of some kind for your tenants. And if you lose, or you transfer vehicles, buy a new car, you need a new sticker, the replacement is a $5 fee. And the only other real changes in here, where it said Selectmen, we changed it to Select Board. To reflect the realities of the public place. I don't believe there's anything else. So I'll open it for a public comment. Going once, going twice.
If no one's interested, huh?
No, it's...
Do you know how many times I've already heard all of this?
If there's no other interest, we will... You know what, why don't we just sit here for a moment. We'll see if anyone comes in. Give it this just 6, so... Or, I'll recess the public hearing.
Okay.
We'll reopen it if anyone comes in to talk to us. How's that? So we will recess the public hearing until 6:15. All right, I'll just do it. All right, we'll reopen the public hearing on the transfer station ordinance change. I've reopened the public hearing,
thank
so
you.
I'll wait for you to sit down and then close it. We'll close it again.
No,
they were here. Okay, so is there anyone here to speak for the public hearing on the change to ordinance 93.1? Seeing none, we will close the public hearing at 6:17. First order of business.
I got the 13th one here. Is this the right agenda?
It's the right agenda. It's the wrong date. Today is the 20th. We're not going to repeat last week.
Okay.
I hope.
I just changed.
Groundhog Day here in Rollinsford. So first order of business is approval of the August 6th minutes. And first of all, I owe Sally an apology. I went back and was going through my emails, and I actually did suggest it. So you were right. I was wrong last week. And you accepted them, and I appreciate that. So I didn't have any other edits for the 6th, and I didn't propose any for the 13th. So by
consensus,
we will adopt both the 6th and the 13th minutes. Community input. First opportunity for community input of the evening. Seeing none, we will move into department head business. We will start with the highway department. because they're here. If you guys want to come on up, we can talk about whatever you have to talk about, and then we can go into the non-public personnel.
Well, we have hydraulic lines that going on back all last week.
Say that again, sir?
Yeah, a couple hydraulic.
Hydraulic line, okay.
And we went over the board, you know, limit of course.
Yeah.
I got the over $326.04 to Kent Body Works and truck repair and rail work to make our lines for us.
Okay. Why don't we have you move it, then we can talk about it.
Move PO 1484 from Mick Body Works in Maine, Burke, Maine, for three hydraulic hoses for the backhoe for $326.04.
Second. Okay, so.
We've been over $2,000 that we had come in and do what we did.
That was my question. So you guys put them in yourself?
Well, thank you.
All right, is there any other questions about it? All right, so all those in favor of purchase order number 1484 for $326.04, signify by saying aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? All right. What else we got?
I think I purchased $2,000 worth of crush gravel to finish the project. I don't know which one it happened for around the project. We had watched them in the year to stockpile so we could have to do some projects.
Yep.
This is kind of a lot of the road for fun.
Yep.
I move purchase order 1486 to Pike Industries, 3/4 inch crushed gravel, not to exceed $2,000, or is that a good price?
Just $2,000, we need more work on that.
Okay, for $2,000.
If we don't use it all, then we don't use it.
Second. Okay, so that was the other question. So, this is to finish some of it in the stockpile, a little bit if we have some leftover.
Right, we got a couple projects we're going to be digging out, putting gravel into, so we want to have some available. Mm-hmm.
Any other questions? All those in favor of purchase order number 1486, say aye.
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? All right. Oh, now what I can do on the last one.
Data.
It says 820.
Oh, perfect. That's almost right for me.
We are having hydraulic issues with the skid steer.
Okay.
The valve has got an internal leak in it, causing the equipment to drop.
All right.
When we're using it for other issues. And I got a quote from Bob out of New Hampshire for $3,567.60.
Okay.
The valve itself is 24 inch long.
Oh, small.
And that's taken it out and repairing it. And you know, the CIP the way it was.
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
So, I'm sorry, what is the skid steer used for?
Roadside mowing, transfer station, everything, the snow blowing and everything right now.
Okay.
To explain some of the issues we have with the snow blower on that
front.
Yeah, that would. Alright, so it's going to come out of vehicle repair and maintenance. How much is it? $3,500? $3,567.60. Okay. Alright, so you've got. So I have enough in there right now, so. Alright.
And of course, these other people come out of that same line, so. But I think we should be in pretty good shape. Hopefully, do it some stuff, but you know, we keep knocking on with.
So you have a
PO for Burke, New Hampshire, and we'll get it scheduled to get it up there.
Okay. PO 1427 moved to a valve replacement on the skid steer for Bobcat of New Hampshire, $3,567.60.
Right, I'll second it. So do we have any other questions for?
Is Bobcat the only option?
They made it.
No, it's the age and yeah, it's
yeah, unfortunately, that's not
going to happen. It works fine until it heats up, and then everything, you hit one button, and everything goes.
Something else moves.
Something else moves, and then it's not safe.
Okay. No, I'm just saying, is that manufacturer the only place you can go?
Oh, and Bobcat built the machine.
So they would be the one. Okay.
Anybody that's else awesome. That would work on it would buy the pad from Bobcat.
Okay, and so there's more.
Yeah.
Okay.
It's just over 1,000 hours on this.
Okay.
Just
yeah.
Yeah, because it's all working out.
Right. Alrighty. Any other questions? If not, all those in favor of purchase order 1427 say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Alright. I need this to be working because something tells me we're going to get snow this winter. And the sidewalks will want to be plowed.
I saw that too,
yeah. And we're going to be using it to crush glass, right? And
bale stuff.
Bale things. And we're going to need it. Yeah. So let's get it fixed. We can't afford a new one.
Alright.
anything else besides personnel issues? So apparently it was in the paper this past weekend that Dover's gonna start this week.
They were actually gonna, they thought they might get there today.
But they didn't tell us. I didn't.
Correct.
Okay.
However, they didn't pay it today.
Right, fair enough, but.
And they are moving into the night schedule, so it's gonna eliminate a lot of traffic.
Oh, they're gonna do it at night?
Because they're in town, they're gonna be doing some other roads at night, so I got an email this afternoon from Joe Bushy saying that they're probably gonna do it on a night schedule with not so much traffic.
Well, that's a great idea.
So we'll send out a notice saying.
Not sure what day this week.
Sometime this week, in the evening, they're gonna be repaving over.
Yeah, this week, okay.
Stay tuned.
I saw the barriers were there today.
Well, he brought the barriers in case they thought they were gonna move my job to another day and do it, and then apparently they decided to wait to do it on a night schedule, so.
Do we have anything else besides non-public?
Showroom is gonna be in town to repair Foundry Street.
Oh, good, okay, yeah.
This week.
Oh, good.
Maybe tomorrow.
Okay.
And I was talking to John from Showroom about the spot on Church Street right by the garage.
Yeah.
He's doing the same thing.
Yeah.
And at the foot of Locust and Main, we were gonna dig it out and stuff. He says, I can plane that for you. I said, what are you gonna charge us to plane it? He says, Pike's paying me for the day to be here to fix that job. He says, I'm moving my equipment. He says, I'm not gonna charge you anything because there's not enough work.
Okay.
So he's gonna grind it for us and
perfect.
David, I said.
Well, wonderful. Okay, that's a good thing. Appreciate that for sure. Make sure you're thankful for it.
He said, they're paying me for the day. I don't have no place else to go after they get here. And straight down the street, I can run the machine across the road. I'll do it for you for nothing. So.
Wow. We like that kind of thing. I like those connections. All right. Anything else? Okay, so we will just so everyone understands, we're going to go into non-public session to deal with something with the highway department, and then we have one from last week in administration we need to deal with, also personnel. Then we'll come back. I'll let everyone know to come in.
Okay.
So if you want
to. Motion to go into non-public for personnel issue.
Second. All those in favor? Mike, yes.
Yes.
Denise, yes. We were in non-public session for personnel issues.
Thank you.
One, actually.
You got 7-1. All right. I'll agree with that.
Okay, so. I'll wait for you to sit down somewhere, sorry. Alrighty, so the select board took up two personnel issues. Public session, one from last week we have resolved. A new one from this evening, where the select board has decided to terminate a member of the staff of the transfer station, effective immediately.
And we should vote on that?
Pardon?
We should vote on that?
Yeah.
I make that motion.
All right, a second. All those, any discussion? All those in favor? Aye.
Aye.
Aye. Okay. It will be effective, like I said, immediately. We'll send a letter tomorrow. And where are we? Please, I haven't seen the chief yet. I think he is coming in, but.
Okay.
All right, we'll move on to town administration, select board vacancy. I haven't got anything official yet. A couple people have approached me and asked questions, but I'm not going to name names until they officially ask. So I don't want to scare anyone off that may be considering. So, but we had said, we were hoping to have applications or letters of interest at least in by the 24th. If we don't get any, we might have to extend it, so. Or we can leave it vacant. I mean, we prefer not to do that, but no one wants to step up. We can't draft people, so. So we'll move on?
Yep.
All right. Town hall maintenance under budgets. I have connected with Patrick Alley, who gave me a couple of names yesterday or the day before last. He gave me a list of 4 or 5 contractors I need to reach out to. So we have names. I don't know if the budget's going to allow for it, but we should at least get quotes and see if we can get the portico shorter.
Be like,
we thought it was going to be like a couple of thousand.
Yeah, but we're really tight.
Yeah,
so.
Well, I agree. But maybe if we can get at least an estimate, we can get it in for next year. I prefer not to, but I'd like to get it done this year. But. Okay, so we will hold off on that one and table it. At least till I hear back from some contractors. Transition plan, Caroline had given us some spreadsheets regarding where we might be able to, do you still have yours, Ron?
I don't.
Okay.
That's
so
okay, I'll listen.
There were a couple of places we had asked her to look to see what we could find.
Yeah, I did review it.
Some money. And so she came up with a few places under the executive budget. I don't think that was the only budget that was touched, actually. So the police chief, he's not, Bob's not here, and Mark's not here for the fire department, but they both did agree and understood that they may be called upon. We have to shuffle some more lines around, and they were willing to do that. She was suggesting moving, where is it? Money out of the finance and admin secretary line, some out of the admin clerical support, some out of mileage, and some out of IT hardware and software and services. I think I'll make sure I'm not misspeaking. I think there was one of the, I thought there was one other place, but I don't see any other green highlights. So we could make up the difference for the shortfall in insurance and have the 4,300 for additional dollars to cover the additional hours we would ask her to work through the end of the year. So the good news is that we have places where we can move things around. We have several options. And there's also under professional services, we could move some around there. I have not moved back from when, apparently Suzanne had moved a few things around already, and we agreed to them, or I should say apparently, because we did agree to them. The electricity at Town Hall, she had almost doubled that.
And it
was
18, right?
To 18, yeah. We'll see what the next couple of months show us. I don't believe that we will need that much, but I could be wrong. But the next couple of months, I think we'll start to show the trends, because we will be out of the cooling season soon, so, or hopefully soon. We haven't had the oppressive heat at least this past week, so that should probably help with the air conditioning costs. Also with the replacements in the air conditioning units downstairs, the different components, hopefully that will help as well. But I think we will be able to make it. So if we were, there may be under, I'll let the police chief speak to what he thinks, and we might be able to move some things around if he wants to do it, moving forward, but we don't need it for right now. So if we want to, we can certainly approve the additional hours for administrative support, because we can cover it, and we can make sure that the insurance underestimate is taken care of. So, and I've made sure that we've made note that we won't be underestimating payments for insurance moving forward.
Mm-hmm.
For next year's budget, okay. Which we're going to talk about in a moment too. So do you want to, are you prepared to make a motion this evening to cover? You have your brochure.
Yeah.
Your print is much bigger.
I'm just
jealous because you can see yours better.
I'm blind.
I can see mine. There you go.
So we're making a motion to go ahead
and increase
with, Caroline's
hours to 40 versus the 32 currently.
I'll make that motion.
Okay. I will second that. Is there any other discussion? Okay, so all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Opposed? It has passed. So we will continue to shuffle the deck chairs as we move through the year. But the one thing I know for certain, we won't be able to take any money as was thought, maybe originally, out of the highway department's maintenance budget.
Yeah, no.
That was never a good idea anyways, but we're
Yeah.
We should look at all options. So anyways, so we have that taken care of at least for now. We could take that off the agenda. 2019 budget planning.
So that's effective immediately for her?
That will start with next paycheck. I think Monday is the, or the next budget. This is a payroll week, so Monday. Is it Monday? Okay, so Monday.
Next payroll week.
Yeah. So starting Monday of the, I should be able to do this on the 27th. Yeah, today's the 20th. I should be able to have 7 of that. Apparently not. Okay, so budget planning. Caroline prepared for us a calendar. Is a map of sorts for the budget process for 2019 with important dates that we can access online.
I couldn't find it.
Okay, so.
I'm going to come in and.
Okay, well, that's all right. All I was going to say is so for next week, what I want to do is I want to forward it. Well, why don't I'll give you a week to activate the self.
I've tried a couple of times and I haven't been able to find it.
So. I want to make sure that all the department heads have access to it as well,
mm-hmm.
which I believe they do. But and let them know that there are drop dead deadlines
mm-hmm.
where they have to have information to us,
mm-hmm.
so we can make sure we have the information prepared to our satisfaction
mm-hmm.
to present to the budget committee,
yep.
so they can do their thing. As we move through this process, we don't have a lot of time, so I want to make sure we're not caught in deadline limbo. So, we'll be prepared to talk about it next week then?
Yep.
Okay, perfect. So, I'm going to stand table till next week, and we'll talk about it then. The residence tax and inventory saga continues. In your folder, when we decided to do away with the inventories,
we didn't sign it
to indicate to the state that we didn't want it.
Right.
So we should do that. So we're saying we will not participate in these any longer, and we will both sign it. So they will know. Caroline will be the contact person, or Andrew. So that's taken care of. I'm still not prepared to decide tonight whether or not I want to keep the residence tax or not. I'm still trying to. I still have some thoughts. I'm not sure. Unless you're. Well, if I'm not ready and you are, or vice versa, I guess we're not getting much done, are we? We've got to be unanimous. So
yeah.
If you don't mind, can we wait another.
I'm fine with that.
Okay.
I'm kind of.
Okay, so we're kind of in the same place.
I'm going to be able to find more.
Well, for sure, right? Well, exactly, right? No, I get that. We've already, by not having the inventories, we're doing away with that penalty payment, so we need to figure out for there, too. So, anyways, transfer station revised ordinance. We had a public hearing this evening. Did you want to act on the proposed? There were no proposed changes from the public, for sure. There wasn't anyone from the public that wanted to speak to it. So, are you ready to act on it, or do you want to wait a week?
I'm fine. It's what we already talked about, right?
Yeah. Yep. So, the ordinance itself was the changes that we outlined the last time we spoke about it. The biggest thing is the who's a resident. Who rather qualifies for a sticker? A resident, mm-hmm. not a property owner. So that takes care of the landlord issue.
Mm-hmm.
And it also lines it up with the minimum housing standards ordinance we passed, so it's more than 4.
Mm-hmm.
Has to have a dumpster or some other means of removal. This will also help clear up any confusion, I think, on the front office too as to who qualifies and who doesn't.
Okay.
So I hope. And it changed to gender neutral select board, which I think is appropriate. And the fee.
And the fee schedule.
We have a $5 fee for replacement,
yep.
because there was the issue of transferability of stickers.
Right.
And who can transfer and how and all that. So that's also in there. It's just from previously registered vehicle to the newly registered vehicle.
Right.
So there's no confusion as to whether or not you had one before or not.
Mm-hmm.
So if we're ready, we should we sh- should probably, we could do them together, so you could do the move the adoption of amendment to ordinance 93-1 and 93-1 fee schedule.
Okay. You making a motion?
I'll do it, sorry.
Okay.
I'll move that we accept the changes that outlined in the amendment to 93-1 dated. Where is it? There's supposed to be a date on it. 8/20.
8/20, yeah.
8/20/18. And the fee schedule also dated 8/20/18.
Second.
Okay. Any discussion? All those in favor, aye?
Aye.
Aye, okay. So we have revised. That's what the word revised. Revised on August 20th, 2018. And I will make sure that we get a, we voted this evening to accept it. Next week we will have a copy that we can sign.
Okay.
And then it will actually become official.
Okay.
But I'm just saying, the revisions are the revisions dated this evening. So when we're looking back, this new amendment becomes the amendment 93-1 of 28, 8/20/18. Easy for me to say it, Karen. Okay, moving right along. Revised transfer station ordinance. Planning ZBA file management. Caroline has a proposal to help, and I do think it really will help streamline the planning / ZBA / assessing files. Her plan is to combine the three files. Mm-hmm. We currently the planning and ZBA files are, as Charity will say, a mess at the moment. There will be one file mm-hmm. per property. Mm-hmm. So currently it's by last name and date mm-hmm. For planning and ZBA, but all assessing is all by map and lot. And mm-hmm. So it's difficult to have a history of the lot, which mm-hmm. is really what you need. It's not the person, it's the lot and the changes associated with the lots. So her proposal is to have all the assessing records are in her office currently, so she will begin slowly as she did with the assessing records, to create separate files per lot and color code. I don't know whatever color she picks. Planning will be one color within the folder, and zoning changes would be a different color within the folder, and then assessing whatever color is currently. So are we okay with that change?
Well, my only concern was that how often do the planning or the zoning board need to access these files, because those are in locked doors that only this Board of Selectmen and Caroline can get into.
Yeah, they would just need to make arrangements
with her at
or whoever, oh. Right? Yeah.
Oh, okay. Whoever all right, because it wouldn't be available as it is now to them.
Well, you're right, but I mean, to be honest, they couldn't find anything in there if they wanted to. I mean, let's
no,
be honest.
I'm sure it's true. But I just wanted to make sure that I understand how they were going to get in there.
We had a conversation actually about large maps,
mm-hmm.
like multi-page large mm-hmm. maps that are kept. For planning purposes, especially, Mr. Crouch showed how it's actually possible to fold down a 5, 6, 7, 8-page document, so it's actually very flat and will fit into a folder. So it's possible. So we will be actually keeping the actual large.
You wouldn't want to get a cabinet that they make cabinets for these large maps.
We have some.
Oh, you did.
And
okay.
It's next to impossible to actually find anything because
oh.
they get so heavy.
Yeah.
Like trying to find.
Okay.
That is the way that used to be done.
Okay.
And to me it made sense as well, because it stays flat, but apparently that's not the way most towns do it anymore.
And she also was talking about taking some space in the select board's office.
Yeah, we mm-hmm. may need to put a couple of filing cabinets in there. Not of assessing, but of some other stuff that she has.
Well, what her other, yeah,
so
her other work
needs
to go
to. So we need to talk
about
rearranging. Which
do we even know what are in those file cabinets in there?
In where?
In the select board's.
In the actual select board?
Yeah.
Do we have any files?
Well, there's something behind my desk.
Yes, there is. And that one is all, I have them all written down. I have a spreadsheet on the files.
Okay, so, and we also have the vault.
And it's something
we
have to keep.
Want to touch the vault.
Well, they need to, what I've done is I've identified everything mm-hmm. and put a location on it mm-hmm. in terms of drawer. But no, there's things in there that but until Caroline has time to look at things, but most of those are very important things.
So she will present a plan to us, how she would envision rearranging the board office. It's obviously, it's our call, we do it or not, but it's our space, but.
But it's not a space that we use often enough, but we do need to have a space that we can go into.
We do.
To work, especially budget time and stuff.
Yeah, we will.
But maybe we don't need to have all of that space. I'm not opposed to it at all, I'm just, I'm.
Or we, you know, we have a lot of what I would call dead space in between.
Yep.
It's like a U, does it need to be a U? It might, we could do a square, or no, rectangle. We could push them together. I mean, there are.
There are options, I think. I agree.
I mean.
And it might be just easier to have three tables versus those.
I was gonna say that, we might not even need desks anymore, I mean, I.
They're so useless, there's nothing in that you can deal with it. That my desk has all those pivots on the top, and you can't, you can't.
It becomes a catch-all, yes, I mean, I, there's.
You know, so it might be easier just to, well.
Half the things on there are mine.
From Mica desk, a table, but, you know.
The prisoners have a metal scrap place.
Well, anyway, let's not get ahead of ourselves. Anyway, so there are options, but as far as the planning and the file management, are we okay with the beginning of the consolidation of these three files?
Yeah.
I mean, to me, it really makes a lot of sense.
Yeah.
When it was explained, especially given that planning, it's, we have, I think we have a vested interest in knowing and being able to present. We had someone come in who wanted information on a parcel that he was presenting on. Kevin McAndy came in to talk about a parcel on Selectmen's Road and said, oh, do you have the file? I'm like, we have no idea what it is. We couldn't, and it was not that long ago. I mean, it was like 10, not even 10 years ago. So, the Paul's integrity is only 3 or 4 years ago. So, yeah.
Yeah, I'm okay with it.
It didn't,
yeah,
so.
She wants to take it, and that's.
Okay, I will let her know that. By consensus, we were okay with her beginning to change the files around. So. Recreation. You have a meeting tomorrow night.
I have a meeting tomorrow night. I'll know more tomorrow night. I don't really have a budget update. I had one from Dee, but I really want to see Caroline's. Because that's.
Right. So I talked to Caroline a little bit about it today.
Yeah.
This is a payroll week.
Yeah.
So, because I said, oh, so do we have the final budget number? She goes, well, yes or no. We have, so payroll is this week, but she's just waiting. She wants to make sure there aren't any outstanding bills coming from them. She doesn't believe there are. She believes she has everything, but she wants to wait until after your meeting tomorrow night, she said, to make sure that there isn't anything that they haven't made her aware of. So I said, okay, fair enough.
Put a big note to
myself. I'd rather have the, you know, the right information, accurate information.
Right, because this last week was her last week, so it should be in this week's payroll, all over the payroll, right?
I would think.
Yeah, okay.
I would hope. I can tell you, I mean, I just as an aside, that at least from one child's perspective, she thought it was great, she loved camp, and it's certainly a very necessary, I think very necessary program if we can make it work the right way for folks in town.
Yeah,
there
I think
a lot of families that took advantage of it.
And it was,
maybe we need more, but
most
pay more. Too,
positive,
so.
Most of it was positive. There's a few.
Yeah,
it's,
but
we're
probably,
we're just
right.
Still in the transition of getting the program up and running and stuff, and starting the new one.
It's volunteers trying to.
And yeah, and so I think that
team.
We're, you know, like I said, I'm going to work with Dee on the budget for this coming year, because we really, my opinion is we have to raise it a little bit.
I agree.
Or stop some field trips or something,
yeah.
And we have to do, it's going to have to happen one way or the other.
Right.
So.
They're gonna, yes, exactly.
So.
I
we'll
mean,
talk
I,
about that too.
As someone paying, I honestly believe you got to pay more. You're going to have to pay a little more. I mean, I don't
and
know
let's look at the people,
numbers,
because
but.
If you're talking daycare versus, you know,
oh,
camps,
oh, yeah.
It, there's no comparison. I mean, it's three times the amount of for that campus for daycare, so.
Oh, for sure.
You know,
for sure,
even
so.
With before and after care.
Yeah, no, exactly. So,
I think that, you know, we can go up a little bit.
I agree. And I'm looking forward to seeing what the final budget numbers are in next year's proposals. All right, so we'll table the budget update under rep for next week when you have hopefully all the details for tomorrow's meeting. Filing plans for the planning board. Oh, okay. I was like, didn't we just talk about this? No. So I spoke with, well, the planning board discussed it again this past week, and they're in agreement, they're appreciative that the select board agrees that the tax collector could file again, if that's what we said. We said yes. Last week, so I talked to Andrea about it today, she's still very much willing to do it. She's trying to remember, she's looking back through her records, whether or not it was, she believes it was a fee that she was paid. It was separate, it wasn't through her payroll, so like the town cut her a check. It wasn't very frequent, I mean, it's like quarterly or something, as she needed to go over and file them, but, so it wouldn't be like, if, we assume it will take approximately 3 hours of staff time, mm-hmm. To file the registry, mm-hmm. Maybe less than that, but that's what we're basing our fee on, that the town charges, so a fee should be covering the actual cost, so we're trying to figure out what her, what the fee the town would pay to Andrea is based
why
on.
Why don't we do it as through payroll though?
Because it's not the same rate as.
I know, but you can still give her a stipend through a stipend for the.
That's fine. I mean,
oh,
maybe we can
okay.
figure that
I
out.
I don't think we should pay
I'm
her.
I'm just saying that's what they did before.
Outside the payroll
that's
system.
That's what she said they did before. That doesn't mean we act to it that way. She hasn't done this for gosh, it's been several years since
okay.
she's done this. So, we can work with Caroline about the,
okay.
the details of the payroll, but she is willing to do it. So,
okay, that's great.
The planning board was suggesting a $50 fee to go to file.
Okay.
And then you would, the applicants would need to bring three checks, one for the fee to the town, one for LCHIP payment to the registry, and then another for the fee to the registry. So they would need to bring three checks, one made out to the town,
mm-hmm.
two made out to the registry.
And then know that way before they come here and then told they have to go home and do it again.
Correct.
Okay.
And, but if for some reason they don't fill out their forms the right
yep.
way, it's not up to, Andrea is going to be delivering them.
She's
not filling them out for them.
Nope.
So if
Got
for
it.
Some reason their engineer or their consulting firm that was doing it for them doesn't do it right,
mm-hmm.
well, she brings them over and wastes her time, she comes back, they got to pay again.
Yeah,
we're
I
not,
get that. Sure.
We're not going to mess around. But we are going to start requiring that the town do it so they actually know for sure these plans are getting filed.
Mm-hmm.
Because we have no guarantee now
mm-hmm.
that things get filed that are supposed to be. So, and then people will come back. I've heard anecdotally in the last several years, people will come back and say, oh, I want to repeal what we did. Or reverse things, and like, well, we have no record of it because you never filed it at the registry. So I don't know how you repeal something or reverse something that never got filed.
So they wouldn't file it probably because there's a cost to it?
Yeah.
Is that why? Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
There is, but it's not official unless you file it.
Sure.
So
yep.
The county needs to know. So that's a good thing. So the town's going to start doing that again. Thank goodness. Transfer station post-closure report. I worked on it today. I need to go over and look at the map that the state is suggesting where they believe it is. I've got to go over and look at the transfer station to see if it is grass over, because one of the questions, which I don't know the answer to, I mean, I do know that we don't have a methane mitigation system over there,
mm-hmm.
for sure, that much I know, and George knows, but do we have a cap?
A what?
A cap. Over, there is a cap over the, that much we know because it's not
yeah.
exposed, right?
Right.
But is it mowed on a regular, is it grassed? Is there a slope to promote runoff? Is it mowed on a regular basis? DES recommends that landfills be mowed twice a year. I asked George and he doesn't believe it has been done because there was never any record and the town was never required to do this before.
Mm.
So we're all learning together. So. But I'm working on it. It's more than halfway done, so.
Okay.
Stay tuned. We will keep it on the agenda, though, because I don't want to lose it.
Right.
And I neglected to say at the beginning of the meeting, and I do apologize, that we're adding something to the agenda, H, abatement appeals. We have five property owners that are appealing the decision of the denial of abatement that we made a couple weeks ago, which is their right. What has been the practice before the Board of Land and Tax Appeal, either the select board can go and represent the town, or the professionals that we pay can go and represent the town, that would be Avatar. What the past practice has been is that we've asked Avatar to go and represent the town, and we've been successful in our...
Well, there's a little note here, would you like Chad...
to do this.
To handle things for the town.
And I would suggest that, yes, we would like the person that's well-versed in how to deal with the Board of Land and Tax Appeal.
So we need to make a motion?
What does it say on the form?
What do you mean, what does it say on the form?
Yeah, I'll move that we have Chad Robarge from Avatar Associates represent the town of Rollinsford before the Board of Tax, Land and Tax Appeal for abatements for 2018.
Who is Todd Kraft?
He may be someone who works in his office.
Is he tax advisors?
Well, those are the folks that are representing the people that
oh,
want the abatement.
Okay. Okay, so there's no, I don't think there's anywhere for us to sign that I can see. Because now it's out of our hands and going to
yep.
state, right?
Yep.
But we still, they still have till September 1st, is that right?
September 1st to file,
okay.
Yep. So there could be more people.
There could be more, so
we will,
should we table it until then?
No, so we just have to make a decision as to whether
oh,
or not we're going to represent
oh,
up the town,
okay.
or if we're going to ask Avatar to represent the town. And I would suggest we have Avatar do it.
Yes.
Because they're the experts.
Right. They're the ones that made those decisions.
Yes.
So they have to stand by them.
Right. We made them.
Well, they gave you that wrong. You're not supposed to have the yellow ones.
So you take that.
Yeah.
Okay. So are we in agreement then that we're going to ask Avatar?
Yep.
Okay. And I don't think we need a vote. By consensus, we will have Avatar represent the town before the Board of Tax and Land. Okay. That's taken care of. Town administration, standing items. Board member activities. I had a planning board last week and we had a few public hearings, but nothing to speak.
What?
But you.
Remember the last couple of weeks I had nothing?
All right, now
I
you
have
do.
Something every day this week.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Tomorrow night I have rec.
Yep.
Wednesday night I have family day, and
oh,
Thursday night I have police space needs.
Okay. Thursday night's going to be here?
They're all here.
Okay. So, Thursday night you're going to discuss whether or not you want to
What our next options,
okay.
because
okay.
based on the public hearing, we haven't really had a meeting since, and we, you know,
yeah, okay,
we need to
fine.
Know what is our next steps to go forward.
Okay.
That's what the police...
To make a
recommendation,
to us. Okay, one way or another.
There was some talk about having the three complexes together.
Yeah.
We don't have negotiation powers to talk to anybody about purchasing land.
Nope.
And so to say, you know, to put that on the committee isn't the right thing, to do.
I agree.
Now, I drove around town and looked at I was like, okay, where can we put this thing? You know, and I was like, I really can't come up with anything that I would believe that it would happen.
Right.
So I don't know what my next step is to do anything about what we're proposing today.
The committee was really supposed to be looking at the needs of the
right.
police station.
Right.
So,
I mean, their proposal was what was discussed at the public hearing.
Right.
And so we either go forward with it, or we don't. Because I don't
or
really.
Or you see if any other options? Yeah.
But I don't know of any other. I mean, the only other suggestions that we received that night was to see if we could make a three-way, you know, complex, in one, you know, and do it all at once. Which
or
would be
or at least two, right? Police and. Town.
Well, that's part of our proposal.
Right.
But
with enough land to
well,
add on eventually.
So people don't think that silver is
right.
an option for that if you're going to expand it. And I
yep.
agree, but I don't know, because say we looked at the other part, we don't want the police station in the woods.
Well, I'll leave it to
know,
the committee to make a recommendation. I don't want
the other one was water issues. So I don't know what we can do
I mean, there are demographic considerations, I would think, that you'd want to consider.
Yeah.
Kim brought that up.
Yeah, so, you know, we'll talk about it, and everyone is going to be able to make it, so that's good.
Okay,
so
well, I'll look forward to hearing.
I should have an update on next Monday.
All right. I'm going to just work on all the little administrative things that I'm supposed to be doing, which are a lot, apparently. Okay, let's do the folder then. So the first thing we have, do you have your stamp with you?
Yes.
In your little box there. So we have a septic, that's good. You know, we've had some issues with some complaints about a septic system on Old Mill Lane while they're replacing it.
Oh, they are.
And here it is. Stamp. I think there's a couple of other things, the actual thing to stamp. This
so where do I stamp it?
Stamp this sheet.
Yeah.
And then sign it. There's maybe two or three, a couple of copies of that needs to be stamped too, just in case.
Okay. And what is the address?
Oh, I'm sorry.
54 Old Mill Lane.
I thought I said it out loud, I apologize.
I only have one.
Oh. And then one it is.
So I'm the only one that signs it?
Yep. Hang alone, sorry.
Hang alone, jeez.
I don't know, that's it. So Mr. Clark's already reviewed it, and that's what really needs to happen. That's what
yeah, there it is. He hangs with me.
Yes. But I mean, before we had this happen, it was just the newest member of the select board apparently got the dubious honor of having a stamp in his or her desk. And we stamp them.
Yeah.
I don't know how many I stamp, but I don't know. The first thing about how to inspect a septic system, I know if it's not working, but
yeah.
It's pretty easy to see. But
is that the only one?
That's it. I have a lot of other things here, but that's the only. There's no building permits to review. Clark was reviewing them. He was in today. He was on vacation last week. So the first thing I have in here, I had a conversation with the town clerk today. We have a request for a refund for motor vehicle registrations. When the town clerk, or any town clerk, enters in, they put a VIN number. When you order register your car, one of the first things he or she does, town clerk, is enter the VIN number. And that tells you what the manufacturer's suggested retail price is.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what the state fees are based off. The town's fees. The state's your standard, based on weight. But the town bases, all the towns base their fees off of what the MSRP is.
Okay.
Well, for some reason, for Nissans, and this is the only manufacturer that this has happened so far that she's noticed, is coming up over what the actual MSRP is. So, for instance, she put in for I don't even know what kind of car this is, some kind of four-wheel drive Nissan, something like that. The state system says the MSRP is $44,000. Well, the actual MSRP apparently, because the person brought in the paperwork, was rounded up to $37,000. So there's a difference of $3,000. And then the other one was $29,000, and the actual MSRP is $27,000. So the state system is not jiving, so Kate's talked to the state, and at least these two individual models of Nissans have been updated. The state's got to update their system further for others, but Kate is aware, and so she's looking for them. Any discrepancies there may be, although I mean she doesn't know every car. So anyway, the point is, this person would like, I believe, deserves a refund of $170.50 that we overcharged.
Now that's the only for the town of Rollinsford share, right?
Correct.
What happens with the state's share?
So the state's share doesn't change because it's based on the weight of the vehicle.
Oh, only on the weight. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So it's, I'm trying to think of what, I think, well, I can't remember, like $43, I think it was the last time I registered one of our cars. I don't even know, it doesn't have it in here what you pay on, but it does. So this person to the state had to pay $59.
So when, is it based only on new vehicles, or is it based on what it is for this year? Because when you have a new vehicle, you have the bill of sale. Why wouldn't you use that?
They did. They brought in, so the window, the thing, right, that hangs in the window, they said, well, actually, the manufacturer retail price is what's on this thing here. It's not, the state admitted that they had...
Right, but why would she charge them for what the state did if it's higher than what she actually has in her hand?
Because people don't bring in the window thing from their cars.
The window
thing? You know, like when you go in, it's got the list of all the, like, the features and things on the car.
I know, but what I'm saying is on new ones. This is only happening on new ones, right?
Not necessarily.
Oh,
this
okay.
one here only happens to be on new ones. But.
Okay. Because when you, I mean, you have your thing that the dealer prepares for you, and that has the value of the car, right?
I don't think, though, that most people, I mean, I certainly, I would never argue. Okay. If she told me, these people pay, or is it, the state, the municipal fees for this vehicle in particular, it must be a heck of a vehicle, was
$792. That's $44,000.
Heck of a car. Yeah. I mean, I don't know. I've never had a $40,000 car, so I don't know. Maybe someday. But I wouldn't argue. I would say, okay, well, that's what the system says.
Well, the system says.
I mean,
me too.
And the same with this one is. This one is a smaller vehicle. $261. Mm-hmm. It would seem reasonable.
So how can she? I'm just saying, how can she stop this from happening? That's my question.
That's a good question. And I don't think she said her answer, as I recall, was that she's just working with the state. That's all.
Well, I saw the email that she sent, and she's going to be working with the state. I thought it said that she's going to try to review them, but I don't know how she
I don't know
catch
how
it.
She will. I okay. don't. I didn't get into that with her.
I just let her.
Yep. I figured that was her thing. So.
Okay.
All we can do is issue the
request for reimbursement. Yeah,
authorize it, and I think it's warranted.
So
the person didn't do anything wrong.
So. You tell me what the dollar is. So I'll make a motion to reimburse Sarah Willett.
Yeah, that's what
it is. A total refund of $170.50 for overcharge on two registrations for 2018.
Second that.
How much?
$170.60. Is 50? Is that 5?
$170.50.
50 cents, sorry.
That's two vehicles. Covers
for two vehicles, right.
All those in favor?
Aye.
All right.
Is that just yours?
Yep. Oh, that wasn't my fault.
Okay.
I don't know why I made any of these. All right. The only other things I have in here for this evening are. So last week we authorized those are five, I think. Let's see. Four. Current use. And this week we have the abatements. Under state law, if the abatement is, or rather the request for current use is issued in the tax year, they get an abatement back for a tax overpayment
from the first half of the year,
right? So, and Andrea suggests it's better to do it now. There shouldn't be an issue with cash flow.
It can't apply to the next half?
It can, but we have to pay them 6% interest. So Andrea would suggest it's better not to have to pay them interest on the money and just pay it now.
Okay.
So, the first one we have is an abatement for map 1-65-3 on Rollins Road in the amount of $3,437. So we're signing these, so we don't have to vote on them. If we both don't vote, we don't both don't sign them, then they don't get their abatement. But
so where's this money come from?
From
the revenue from the previous tax bills?
From, So the short answer is from fund balance, which means when we go to set the tax rate, we have to be mindful of that, so. The next is map, I mean, the money is owed to these people.
I'm signing this back.
The money is owed to these people, we can either pay them now or we can wait till the second half. When the second half payments are due, but even if we wait till December to pay them, we have to pay them 6% interest starting from the day that we granted the abatement to when we pay them, so.
Okay.
We're better off paying them. Map 3-4-0 off of River Road in the amount of $282. Next one is, are you ready, Sally? Sorry. Okay, map 1-65-0, also off of Rollins Road. Where is it? Make sure I'm not doing different ones.
That's the last one. This is the last one.
Okay, $282. Okay, I just want to make sure I read the right number. I'm sorry. I was second guessing myself. I'm sorry. So this one, the 1-65-0 off of Rollins Road, is $3,389. So it's going to be about $10,000. And the last one is map 1-73-0, also off of Rollins Road. And this amount is $7,699. My math was off, it's more than $10,000. And like I said, they qualify for current use, you can't deny it, so that's.
I thought we had more than this, though.
Mm-hmm.
Didn't we have more than
those
before?
Are the ones that we have so far. There are more coming.
Didn't we approve more?
Yes.
Oh.
These are the ones that we are ready for tonight. She's working on.
Oh, okay.
Sorry,
all
if
right.
I just make that clear, I apologize. Okay. So there's a few more coming.
Okay.
I asked her about it. She said, well, if they qualify, you can't deny it. So the only thing is people need to recognize that the rest of us have to make up the difference.
Mm-hmm.
So that's the law.
But if it doesn't stay in current use for a certain period of time, then they have to rebate.
They pay the land use change tax.
Okay.
So, they have to pay quite a bit.
How many years is it that has to stay?
I don't. I know we had a property owner last year who, when Avatar reviewed current use, was found not to be in compliance and paid quite a bit of money. $13,000, something like that. It was a very large amount. So, yeah, it's not something we did cheerfully.
Yeah. You done?
I am, sorry. Right. So I need to send that. To
oh, yeah, I need to send this. Okay, this is a letter to Terry Bennett telling him the proper procedure of for his appeal, his abatement that he's looking for, so it's requiring your signature.
Right, to go to the proper course of action, to go to the Board of Tax and Land Appeal.
Yep.
By September 1st, I will sign.
Okay, and this is lawyer bill for the zoning violations by David LaRoche.
Okay. This is a deal with
the
112 Rollins Road.
This is a lawyer bill for general representation. Dealing with the town audit. LaRoche, year Oak Street. July 17th. For $217.46.
Oh, that's
great.
Look on
the bottom, isn't it? Did
that
have to do with the markers?
Oh, yes. It cost us $35 when I told them and I went out to do the preambulation. So.
Yep.
Sorry, but I had to tell them.
Okay, so.
Okie dokie. So just be mindful anytime we ever email the lawyers for anything. So if it's outside, mean, everyone email them outside of a meeting if we haven't approved, like, oh, by the way, Mike, you're supposed to let them know.
Yeah.
Like, okay, I had to let Kevin Baum know that I did that.
Yeah.
That's what he asked. So if you just had a question for our legal counsel, you want to make sure it's approved by the select board, because anytime you reach out to them, it costs us money, just so everyone knows.
This is a purchase order 1483, Lebel Computer Services for the town office and the police department.
Yeah.
One 10-hour block of IT time, current balance is 0 hours, and the total is $760 coming from the IT hardware software services line.
Are you moving that?
I am moving.
I'll second it. So we buy blocks of hours from Tom, and we're out. So there's another 10-hour block.
Yeah.
And there still will be money in the line, in the IT line, even after. So, okay, all those in favor?
Aye.
Aye. Anyone opposed?
This is a letter from the Rye Zoning Board of Adjustment.
Yep.
Notice of a joint public hearing with Planning Board Verizon Tower application. So is everyone who gets in one?
Anywhere within 50 miles, I believe it is,
okay.
A cell phone tower. Their radius, the coverage area has to be notified.
Okay, it's Tuesday, September 4th at 7 p.m. at the Rye Town Hall. The Rye Zoning Board of Adjustment will hold a public hearing on the application of the Selco partnership doing business as Verizon Wireless for variances and special exceptions to install a wireless telecommunication facility.
Good luck.
So, it's just
Rye,
kind of like an
good luck.
FYI,
Rye is notorious
so we don't really have to do anything
for denying them, and then all the residents complain that they don't have cell phone coverage. So, good luck.
Voting delegate authorization, New Hampshire Municipal Association is looking for Town of Rollinsford to have a voting delegate authorization, someone appointed.
Yeah, so they have a policy forum every year.
Mm-hmm.
We are either allowed as select board members to go and represent our town,
mm-hmm.
and go and to listen, but one person has to be appointed to actually vote on these. So these are recommendations by other select boards and zoning boards or other from member towns,
mm-hmm.
to bring forward on behalf of those towns by the Municipal Association to the legislature.
Yep.
To change state law. I looked at a couple of them. If you have a desire to go to the meeting,
I do not.
We can have you be the appointee if you want. It's on Friday, September 14th. And then, so one of them, actually one of them I think is really important. They're all important to someone for some reason, but the town of Holderness, the town of Litchfield, the town of Albany, and the town of New Durham, I'm sure amongst others, but these are the ones that officially submitted, are asking the New Hampshire Municipal Association to support legislation that would clarify that the town moderator has the authority to postpone the official ballot voting session at the town meeting in the event of severe weather, and not the Secretary of State sitting in Concord. The person actually in the town is dealing with the town. So I think that's a great idea, but it's going to happen anyways. The association's been fighting this fight for a couple years now. They're going to do it. But and then there's one about watering lawns during droughts. We have the authority to tell residences, residential property owners they can't do it,
mm-hmm.
but we can't tell businesses.
Okay.
So. The town of Bedford is suggesting that we be allowed to tell, like if we were going to tell wetlands that they can't water their stock down there during a drought.
But they're not even on wetlands of water, right?
They're on
Dover.
They're on Dover.
Yeah. So
that would be a poor example. Let's see. I don't know who else could we pick
on. There really isn't anybody.
If there were,
Janko wouldn't be either.
Yeah, Janko doesn't want. We could tell them they can't water their front lawn.
The one, the new refinery there. Maybe?
Yeah, I don't know.
There isn't very many.
There isn't, for sure.
Sanders,
but anyway, apparently the town of Bedford thinks it's a problem. So, and it may be for them. But and then Hudson wants to talk about. Lower the abatement interest rate that municipalities pay from 6% to 4%. So what we just did.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, Hudson wants to be able to wait a little longer and pay. If they have to wait, they only have to pay 4% interest and not 6%. But maybe I don't know. The legislature will never allow it because, I'm sure they get a pass on it. So we need to decide by a date certain if one of us is gonna go, or if we're gonna send Caroline and any other employee that wants to go to this, so. Or we just don't go, I mean, there's that, also that, we have done that in the past, so. Is that the only thing we have to hold?
Nope, so this is a hold?
Yeah. We have a burning desire to go.
We have a letter from CASA, looking for $500 in the next funding cycle, so I would just recommend holding it for our next prior budget.
Yeah. Do they list in their, so, well, yeah, we don't do it, right? A lot of them will list what services they provide to the town of Rollins, I don't know.
Overall, we've seen 49% increase in the number of cases we have been asked to take by the courts in the past 2 years. I don't think it's not really addressing Rollins for just.
I didn't know if they had.
In general.
If they had information specific to us, but I know they do very important work, and they're really busy, especially with the drug issue.
What is this sample policy for review in the US of tobacco products?
So, this was, this is not for tonight, this is just a whole.
It's just an FYI?
Yeah, so we had on the agenda, I might have told her to take it off for now, but until we had some slow time, but until we get the budget down, we're not gonna have any, but remember there was, we had some folks that wanted to have smoking ban at the transfer station.
No smoking at the transfer station, yep.
And other town properties, well, we have to have some sort of policy. So this is the, I said I would look for things, this is the town of Bristol's use of tobacco products and equipment ordinance. I'm not suggesting that this is what we would do, but it's just a place to start, I guess, so. But I would suggest we just table it.
Okay.
I think we have other issues we need to deal with first. How's that?
Sure.
Secondhand smoke is not an issue.
Still working on that?
Yeah, please don't, yeah, please.
And we're gonna hold this one.
Yeah, it's the 14th of September, I might actually go to talk about it, so it's in Concord, right, now that I saw.
Let me see.
Or Manchester, either way, it's. It's a Friday?
Friday, September 14th.
Busy day, man.
At New Hampshire Municipal, at 25 Triangle Park Drive in Concord.
So it's in Concord?
9 AM.
Is that 9?
Uh-huh.
Yeah, I could move some things around. I have a 1:30 that I can't cancel, but I might be able to go there, so I'll do it.
Okay.
Why not? Town of Rollins for. Represented by. Look at my calendar right now, so I don't forget.
Okay, so this Department of Revenue, you're gonna take care of the 2017 assessment review? Is that what you said? Is that the one?
Yes, yep.
Okay, so that's still in the pending?
Yep.
Need to see it. And that's all I have for.
Alright. Give me all just a moment, we're going to the public comment, but I don't want you to think I'm ignoring you. I want to just make sure I get this in the calendar.
I also have a question.
Sure.
Is the Board of Selectmen required to be at the polls?
Yes, we should talk about that too.
Kind of didn't know about that.
Well, there's lots of things we don't tell you to make sure that people will run. No, just kidding. That was really a joke. Hold on. I'm not trying to ignore you, I just want to make sure I don't forget about this, because
okay.
I will and I don't want to, so it starts at 9, say 9 to noon, and after that, I don't know. And we'll find out where it's at. Okay, it's in there. Yes, so.
Are we all required to be there?
Yes, well, so state law says for certain elections we have to be there.
Okay.
And I'm going to be there anyways. and I don't remember, I think I might be misremembering, if it has to be just town elections or if it's just state and federal elections. But there also is some, I think some folks that would disagree with the interpretation as to whether or not you have to be there at all or just certain elections. I've always just said we have to be at all of them, and I've gone to all of them. There was a time when there wasn't any select board members at the election, so.
I mean, I'm not prepared to do the one coming up. I can
September.
Come after my hours, after I get out of work. I can't spend the whole day.
That's fine. I don't think anyone's going to come find us. Maybe they will, but I don't think they will.
Okay.
I'll be here. I mean, so the select board, by statute, is required to do certain things for the election. We have to make sure there's an American flag in the room.
Okay.
There's one here, and there has to be an American flag outside of the polling place.
Okay.
There is one. We have to select the polling location.
Okay.
That sort of is a bone of contention with some people, but the statute says we actually select the place. And I haven't thought about it, but I think it's going to be here. It's a primary election, it's not going to be all that busy. What else do we have to do? Make sure the polling location is secure and accessible. And in the mail, before I forget, you should have gotten a very large, heavy envelope from the Secretary of State. It has all the new election laws in a binder, or in a bound, like a ring thing like
today?
This. Last week.
No.
Okay. I will, I had to be there at my conference tomorrow. I'll stop at the State House and
okay.
Ask them why you weren't sent one. See if you're on the
do
list.
Do they know about me?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Well, okay, they may not know about any of us, but they're
right.
Told that the
yeah.
List is sent to them.
Oh, okay.
By, so the town clerk is responsible for sending, and she does, and she has, sent the list in that has all of the newly elected officials.
Okay.
And so they should have updated it. Not everyone gets one, but the select board and like moderator, the clerk, and probably the supervisor of the check, like the imaginary supervisor, so you're going to get one.
Okay. No, I didn't get it.
Okay.
Okay, so every, at least every town election? You're
every
saying
election
we're
supposed to be right there.
Okay.
So that's at least...
it's three this year, the remaining year, right?
Two this year.
Two, that's right.
For this year, and then next year, what's that? That's an off year, that's
just the
one, the town election.
The town, okay.
And then when it's a presidential year.
Oh, good God.
Yeah.
Maybe I'll be retired by then. I don't have a problem.
So,
okay.
You know, I'll double check with them in Concord. I'll ask what the requirement is for it.
I mean, I can be there, you know, certainly from the time I get out of work to the end of it.
You know, I don't know if it's really reasonable to ask working people to take a day off work, but I didn't make the loss. But I'll check with them to see what the... My understanding was it was for all the elections, but now that I'm saying it, I think I've read it again, and it's a certain ones. And they were actually trying to change the law this past year to say that the select board member were designated. But it didn't pass. So.
Just so I can make another comment,
yep.
is that I think that we should consider changing our location for our elections as well.
Okay.
To the Legion.
For all of them?
I think so.
Every single one?
Mm-hmm. There's parking, there's room, you know, especially in the winter, it's all one level.
Yeah.
And, you know, I think if you grant me the right to do it, I will get in contact and ask them what they think the fee would be.
We've asked them before, they were willing to waive it.
And so if we can get that in writing, then why can't we? I mean,
so this has been the, I'll tell you what, we've discussed it before.
Mm-hmm.
It doesn't mean we shouldn't discuss it again, and we probably will. For the larger elections, the clerk, and the clerk does all the logistical moving of things and the setting up of the polls and all of that. For the smaller elections, she doesn't think the logistics of moving everything is worth it. I'm not saying that's right or wrong, but that's what I've been told. For the larger elections, like the presidential election, or even the state general election, she thinks about The turnout is so small, typically for the state primary elections.
Okay.
And arguably, back and forth over the years, even town elections, I think they should be down, town elections should be down to get the weather.
Well, just because of
parking
here is terrible.
I agree, but.
And so, I mean, I think we should make it as easy as possible for the people who are coming up to vote.
I agree.
And they may come out more if you have places that they can park and
Yeah.
they can get into it, and, you know, it's all handicap accessible, no elevators, no, you know, I mean.
I don't disagree with it. So we,
We picked the location, right?
We do. We need to have that conversation. I've kind of double checked though, and I don't know if we did pick the location for every election.
Okay.
Might only be for certain elections. That's why I've got to go back and look at it.
Okay. I won't do it now, but we can kind of put it back on the table for a conversation, I think.
So we can add to the agenda for next week, because it's coming up.
We've still got some, well, we can't really do the primary right now.
Well, we can't now, because it's too late, because the warrant for the election has already been posted, and that's, it's up there for September 11th, and it's for here.
Yeah, no, we don't have to do this one. But, you know, I think definitely, and being that it's going to be an SB2 as well, you're going to get more and more people, and I just want to have it be as safe
Yeah, I agree.
and as available as possible for everyone.
No argument from this side, other side of the table.
So we should really look into that.
Okay. Anything else?
No, I think I said enough.
That's fine. Community input.
Yeah, just a simple question. When's the space needs? Is it the 23rd or the 30th?
What are you talking about?
Your space, needs.
The police one?
Yeah.
It's Thursday.
Yeah, it's posted the 30th.
Oh, they missed him. She must have misposted it. What's the 30th? That's that next
That's a week from this Thursday.
A week from
Thursday. I will have her correct that.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
Yeah. I know she posted it. She told me she did, but I will talk to her. Thank you.
Anything else? All right, well, by consensus, we will adjourn the meeting at 8:06.
Outside warm up.